Hello friends, welcome again. In last lecture we will see the properties and the structure of myoglobin, and we know that myoglobin also acts as an oxygen carrier or dioxygen molecule in which oxygen is present, or it is oxygenated myoglobin. It is also called as oxygenated myoglobin, and it is similar like hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is a red blood protein and myoglobin is a muscle protein, and hemoglobin is oxygen carrier, myoglobin is oxygen storage, and because of he act as oxygen storage protein, he give oxygen whenever we need the oxygen. So at that time myoglobin supply its storage oxygen. That is the main function of myoglobin. After that we will see the difference between hemoglobin and myoglobin, which is little bit or not a major difference between the hemoglobin and myoglobin. Okay, now the third dioxygen molecule is hemoglobin. And we already know that there are four naturally occurring dioxygen molecule or complex which act as a oxygen carrier or which act as a oxygen storage in the living system, and we already finished the first two, hemoglobin and myoglobin. This is the third one, that is the hemerythrin. Okay, we know that hemoglobin and myoglobin are the IR porphyrin complex, and porphyrin is porphyrin ring manje kay? It is a macrocyclic ring which is made up of pyrrole or four pyrrole. In the center of that ring, iron, metal or any metal atom is present. Such a macrocyclic ring is called as porphyrin ring. Okay, in hemoglobin, iron also present in the porphyrin ring, or hemoglobin is a porphyrin ring containing complex. After that, myoglobin. Myoglobin is also a porphyrin complex in which iron atom is present in the porphyrin ring, but the third one is hemerythrin. Okay, and the molecule in which porphyrin ring is present, such a molecule is called as heme complex. But in hemerythrin, the porphyrin ring is not present, so hemerythrin is a non-heme protein complex. Hemerythrin is also represented as HR, is non-heme protein complex. Non-heme protein complex. Okay. Porphyrin ring does not present. Porphyrin ring does not present. Okay, so because of no porphyrin ring present in hemerythrin, the hemerythrin is a non-heme protein complex. Iron is present, okay, iron atom is present, but that microcyclic ring or porphyrin ring not present in the hemerythrin. Okay, it having 8 polypeptides. It have 8 polypeptides. It having 8 polypeptides. Okay, just like in hemoglobin, there are 4 polypeptides are present. In myoglobin, 1 polypeptides are present. Just like that, in hemerythrin, 8 polypeptides are present, and that 8 polypeptides are converted into the monopeptide. These 8 polypeptides converted into monopeptide. Polypeptides are converted into the monopeptides, and each monopeptide having 113 amino acids. Each monopeptide children have 113 amino acids. Listen, we already see the first two dioxygen molecule or complex, that is the hemoglobin and myoglobin, and the third one is hemerythrin. This hemerythrin is non-heme protein, or no porphyrin ring is present in the hemerythrin, and this hemerythrin having 8 polypeptides, and these 8 polypeptides are divided into the single peptide or monopeptide, and that each one monopeptide having 113 amino acid. So total 904 amino acid present in hemerythrin. So total 904 amino acid present in hemerythrin. Okay, so total 904 amino acid present in the hemerythrin. So we also say that it is a long chain of amino acid, or it contains long chain of amino acid, just like in a hemoglobin. Hemoglobin having 574 amino acid. So it is a long chain of amino acid. Like that, hemerythrin having 904 amino acid. So it also contains long chain of amino acid. So it contains iron atom and oxygen molecule. Okay, it is a non-heme protein, means that there is only porphyrin ring. Iron atom present hai, but so iron atom porphyrin ring madhe present nahi. Jasa ki apla hemoglobin ani myoglobin madhe hota, tasa iron atom present nahi. It having 108,000 Dalton molecular weight. This hemerythrin having 108,000 Dalton molecular weight. Molecular weight of hemerythrin is 108,000 Dalton. 108,000 Dalton. Okay. Now, we already said that the porphyrin ring is not present in hemerythrin. It is a non-heme protein. Okay. But it having 2 iron atom and 1 oxygen molecule. It have 2 iron atom with 1 oxygen atom, or 2 iron atoms bound to the one oxygen molecule. Okay, in this it is a non-heme protein. Ki porphyrin ring nahi hai, tachyamule apan hyala non-heme protein mhanto hai. But there are 2 iron atoms present, and that 2 iron atoms attached to the 1 oxygen molecule. Okay. So see the structure. this Vimrati ring does not have any porphyrin ring. This is the protein structure. Is converted into the oxyhemerythrin. After oxygenation, hemerythrin is converted into oxyhemerythrin. Converted into the oxyhemerythrin. Okay, and this binding is very weak, and due to that weak binding, it easily donates electron, or it acts as a electron carrier or oxygen donor. Okay. The function of hemerythrin is it acts as an electron carrier or oxygen donor. This is the protein matrix. And this is the monopeptide. Okay, and we know that in hemerythrin there are 8 polypeptides are present, and that 8 polypeptides are converted into the single monopeptide, and single monopeptide having 2 iron atom with 1 oxygen molecule, and this binding or this bonding is little bit weak, or weak binding is takes place between the 2 iron atom and oxygen molecule. So they easily release electron and they easily give the oxygen in the living system. So it acts as an electron carrier or oxygen donor. Now this is the reaction. 8 molecule of hemerythrin plus 8 molecule of O2. After oxygenation, this hemerythrin reacted with oxygen and iron atom, and after oxygenation it is converted into the oxyhemerythrin. Okay, this is the third dioxygen or naturally dioxygen complex, that is the hemerythrin. Okay, now the next one is, and the last naturally occurring dioxygen complex is the hemocyanin. Okay. This hemocyanin is also a oxygen carrier. The fourth one is hemocyanin, which acts as a naturally occurring dioxygen carrier. Three molecule or four molecule. Okay, now the fourth one is hemocyanin. Now we already said the last naturally occurring dioxygen complex, and the first three, hemoglobin, myoglobin, and the third one is hemerythrin, having iron atom, and the first two, hemoglobin and myoglobin, having porphyrin ring. So that hemoglobin and myoglobin called as a heme protein, because porphyrin ring is present, and in that porphyrin ring iron atom is present. The third one is hemerythrin. Hemerythrin is a non-heme protein because hemerythrin does not have a porphyrin ring, but it having two iron atom. But the fourth one is hemocyanin. Hemocyanin is also a non-heme protein. It is also non-heme protein. Hemocyanin is also a non-heme protein. No porphyrin ring is present. No porphyrin ring present. It having two copper atoms. It has two copper atoms. Okay, this hemerythrin is, hemocyanin is a non-heme protein. Okay, and no porphyrin ring is present, and because instead of iron atom, hemocyanin having copper atom. Copper is present. Listen, we know that the atomic number of copper is 29. Okay. Its last cell electronic configuration is 3d9, 4s2, or which is also written as 3d10, 4s1. Okay. But its last, in this hemocyanin, copper is present in monovalent state. When oxidation state of copper is 1, and when oxidation state of copper is 1, it having 3d10 or 10 electron in the d orbital, means d orbital is full filled, and because of that no unpaired electron is present, so it is a colorless. In deoxyhemocyanin, or simply deoxy hemocyanin, deoxyhemocyanin is colorless because copper having, because copper present, because copper present in monohalon state, present in monohalon state. means when hemocyanin reacted with oxygen, then the oxidation state of copper is changed and monohalon copper is converted into the dihalon copper, and when oxidation state of copper is 2, it's having 9 electron. Means it having one unpaired electron, and when one unpaired electron is present, that oxyhemocyanin having blue color, and that's why hemocyanin is also called as blue copper protein. Okay. After oxygenation, copper converted into divalent state. So it having blue color. So hemocyanin is also called as blue copper protein. Hemocyanin is also called as blue copper protein. Also called as blue copper protein. Okay, this hemocyanin in which two copper atoms are present, and in hemocyanin the oxidation state of copper is monohalon, means it having plus one oxidation state, and after oxygenation that oxidation state is converted into the divalent, means that copper having plus two oxidation state, and because of plus two oxidation state, after oxygenation it having blue color, that's why it is also called as a blue copper protein. Molecular weight is variable. For species to species, in between 50,000 Dalton to 70,000 Dalton. Okay, this molecular weight of hemocyanin is a variable. It is a different for species to species, and molecular weight is in between 50,000 Dalton to 75,000 Dalton. It having more than 50 subunit of polypeptide. It having more than 50 subunits or polypeptides. Means this hemocyanin having maximum polypeptide, or it is more than 50. It have more than 50 subunit or polypeptide, or polypeptide. Two copper atom binds one oxygen molecule. atom binds one oxygen molecule. Carrier. Okay, so all these four naturally occurring dioxygen complexes are over. First one is hemoglobin, second one is myoglobin, third one is hemerythrin, and the fourth one is hemocyanin. The first two, hemoglobin and myoglobin, are the heme protein in which the iron porphyrin ring are present. But the last two, hemerythrin and hemocyanin, are non-heme protein in which no iron porphyrin ring is present. Only hemerythrin, two iron atoms are present attached with one oxygen molecule, and in hemocyanin, copper atom are present, or two copper atoms are present attached with the one oxygen molecule. Okay, in next lecture we will see the difference between these naturally occurring dioxygen complexes. Okay, thank you so much for watching.